we are asked to simplify the given cube roots. We simplify cube roots just like we simplify square roots, except for cube roots, we look for perfect cube factors of the radicand rather than perfect square factors. Perfect cube factors are more difficult to identify, and therefore, when simplifying cube roots, we normally look at the prime factorization of the radicand. So for the cube root of 64, we'll begin by determining the prime factorization of 64. 64 equals 8 times 8, 8 equals 4 times 2, and 4 equals 2 times 2. 64 is equal to 6 factors of 2. So we have the cube root of 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. Every time we have 3 equal factors, we have a perfect cube factor. Here's a perfect cube factor, and here's a perfect cube factor. So this is equal to the cube root of 2 cubed times 2 cubed, which is equal to the cube root of 2 cubed times the cube root of 2 cubed. The cube root of 2 cubed simplifies to one factor of 2 here and here. We can also think that the cube root undoes the cubing, giving us 2 times 2, which equals 4. The cube root of 64 is equal to 4 because 4 cubed is equal to 64. Next, we have the cube root of negative 125. Let's ignore the negative for a moment and look at the prime factorization of 125. 125 is equal to 5 times 25. 25 is equal to 5 times 5. So 5 times 5 times 5 is equal to 125, but the radicand is negative 125. But if we multiply an odd number of negatives, the product is negative, and therefore we can write negative 125 as negative 5 times negative 5 times negative 5. This shows that negative 125 is a perfect cube. This is equal to the cube root of the cube of negative 5, and therefore this simplifies to one factor of negative 5. Next, we have the cube root of 27x to the sixth. Well, 27 is equal to 9 times 3, and 9 is equal to 3 times 3. So this is equal to the cube root of 3 times 3 times 3. Now, we could write out 6 factors of x, but because we're looking for perfect cube factors, let's write x to the sixth as x to the second times x to the second times x to the second. Notice how we have 3 equal factors, showing x to the sixth is a perfect cube. Now we'll circle the perfect cube factors. Here we have 3 threes. Here we have 3 factors of x squared. So this is equal to the cube root of 3 to the third times x to the second to the third. We can write this as the cube root of 3 to the third times the cube root of x squared raised to the third. The cube root of 3 to the third is equal to 3, and the cube root of x to the second raised to the third is equal to x squared. So the cube root of 27x to the sixth simplifies to 3x squared. I do want to point out that if you have a hard time writing x to the sixth as this product here, we could just expand x to the sixth and write out 6 factors of x. So let's go ahead and show that. We could write this as the cube root of 3 times 3 times 3 times 6 factors of x. And now we circle groups of 3 equal factors here, here, and here. And each group will simplify to one of the 3 equal factors, giving us one factor of 3 here, one factor of x here, one factor of x here, and therefore this does simplify to 3x squared. So either method will work. For the last example, we have the cube root of x to the ninth, y to the third, z to the 12th. X to the ninth is a perfect cube, so is y to the third, and so is z to the 12th. To show this, we'll write x to the ninth as x to the third times x to the third times x to the third. We'll write y to the third as y times y times y. And we'll write z to the 12th as z to the fourth times z to the fourth times z to the fourth. Remember, the exponent rule is when multiplying and the base is the same, we add the exponents. The exponent rule is a to the m times a to the n equals a to the m plus n. Notice 3 plus 3 plus 3 is equal to 9. And for the z's, 4 plus 4 plus 4 is 12. Circling the perfect cubes, here we have three equal factors, as well as here, and as well as here. So we can write this as the cube root of x to the third, raised to the third, y to the third, and z to the fourth, raised to the third, which is equal to the cube root of x to the third, times the cube root of y to the third, times the cube root of z to the fourth to the third. Simplifying, here we get one factor of x to the third, here we get one factor of y, and here we get one factor of z to the fourth. So the cube root simplifies perfectly to x cubed y z to the fourth. I hope you found this helpful.